global cities will dominate the focus of both business and the individual. They are diverse economies with inherent advantages that give owners of real estate strong pricing power.
The cities that we look at in our Global Cities Index are the places that people want to live in, they want to work in, and they want to play in as well. So the offering of these cities is something that people find compelling.
We're looking for a global city that will be very strong economically. We have to have the infrastructure side. We need the infrastructure spend on ports, on airports and tube stations. We want a very strong urban planning regime as well, which will help limit the amount of space. So as a landlord, you can constantly charge a higher rent. And then of course, we want the world-class universities. We need that innovation for the new industries that no one knows about today that we're going to be using in 10 or 15 years. So there's a number of factors that we look for, and all of those with the right balance will give us very strong economic growth. People will earn more money, corporations can pay more rent, whether you're a retailer selling clothes, selling coffee, or working in the financial sector.
A city that we think is very, very strong and very compelling is LA. Myth about Los Angeles is that there is subject to urban sprawl, but in actual fact, it's surrounded by national parks. To the west, it obviously has the ocean. It is almost impossible to increase the level of supply within the city due to height regulation. And in addition to that, it has the infrastructure that moves people, it moves goods, and it moves data across the city, which obviously helps provide good long-term sustainable growth and ultimately makes it a place that people want to be.